Apple is, of course, very well known for its design acumen. Under the leadership of Johnny Ive, they have defined categories and won numerous awards. In fact, all modern Apple products proudly and somewhat pretentiously display "Designed by Apple in California." That's why it's somewhat surprising when many people learn that hasn't always been the case, and in fact, in the past, Apple has outsourced many of their designs. Today we're going to talk about three of those, all consumer electronic products from the 90s. To begin with, let's discuss the Power CD. It is, of course, a CD player. You guys remember those, right? It could play audio CDs, photo CDs, and through a SCSI port, it could be used as a CD-ROM for your Mac. It was also portable, but since it didn't have any skip protection, you definitely couldn't take it jogging. So who actually designed this? Philips. In fact, they released a nearly identical player called the CDF-100 that simply lacked the CD-ROM feature. They also licensed the design to Kodak, which released its own branded version. And speaking of Kodak, that brings us to our next product, the QuickTake camera. Of the three products we're looking at today, this is the one that Apple probably has the most design claim to, although not in the way you might think. The Hour design is mostly from Kodak, while much of the internal technology was developed by Apple. This was actually recently revealed in the legal disputes surrounding Kodak's bankruptcy. When people first see the QuickTake 100 and 150, they often comment on this unusual binocular design. However, this was not an uncommon design for early digital cameras. In fact, the Kodak DC40 and DC50 are nearly identical. Apple, however, abandoned that binocular design with the QuickTake 200. Or rather, Fujifilm abandoned it, since that's who actually designed this camera. In fact, the Fujifilm DS7, of which the QuickTake 200 is a near identical twin, was released before Apple's version was. All of these products and the others like them offer an interesting glimpse into a time when the Apple as we know it didn't exist, when far from being a consumer electronics juggernaut, it was simply a struggling computer company dabbling in some other markets. That's all for this video, guys. Thanks a lot for watching, and I'll see you next time.